Hey guys, MetalViking82 here, back with a new Viking Orations. Got another review for you today, and this time around I'm going to be talking about the debut EP from the band Oxalate, entitled Infatuating Sickness. Now, if you're not familiar with Oxalate, they are a death metal band out of the New York, New Jersey area that have been around since 2017, featuring Devin Ray on bass and vocals, Jacqueline Jackie Betancourt on drums and vocals, and Chris Albertson and Zach Mild both on guitars. As I said, this is their debut EP. It is four tracks, just a little over 11 minutes in length. The CD of it was put out through Horror Pain Gore Death Productions, limited to 100 copies. And other than this EP, the only other material the band has is a song they contributed to a four-way split with Perpetuated, Bloodsport, and Vivisect, which is how I was introduced to this band. And when you listen to this EP, just right off the bat, you're hit with the blast beats and those heavy guitars, which are kind of distorted and dirty sounding. And honestly, they just sound plain mean at times. You get a lot of mid to fast paced riffing with some, you know, slower, chunkier riffs thrown in at times, and some really nice guitar solos. A perfect example of that is the lead off track, Unwholesome Revelation. At about the 150 mark, there's this whammy bar leg guitar solo that just sounds absolutely badass. And these guys definitely know how to settle into a nice headbangable groove. And at times you'll hear a riff with a bit of a black metal feel to it, I think. You know, not much, but just a tinge of it. A good example is that is the closing track, track number 4, Blood and Sulfur, about 43 seconds into the song. That just seems to have like a tinge of black metal to it, to my ears anyway. Really great bass tone on here. It's thick with just a little bit of a fuzz to the tone. Excuse me. And can be easily heard throughout the whole EP, just rumbling away in the background, providing that really solid backbone to all of these songs. And yeah, Jackie's drums on here I think sound really awesome, in my opinion. There's a good snap to the snare. The kick drums have a nice thump to them. And, you know, while her style and playing isn't overly flashy or anything, to me, it's just solid old school death metal style drumming. And she does some really awesome blast beats on here. Vocal wise, you get a really powerful mid-range growl with these really sick and twisted screams that I'm guessing are provided by Jackie herself. And she does a killer job. Those screams are just absolutely sick. The only other thing that really stood out to me on this EP is, or should I say that I kind of took note of, is track number 2, Dark Ritual. I just love that bass intro and then this nice little groove that the song settles into that really gets your head banging right from the get-go. And then at about the 223 mark, you get another nice, really awesome guitar solo with... To me, it has a little bit of a Rick Ross kind of feel to it. You know, maybe it's just me, but when I heard that solo, I was just like, man, that kind of sounds like something Rick Ross would have written. yeah, overall, I think this is a hell of a debut release for this band. It's four tracks of just heavy, dirty-sounding, old-school death metal. And honestly, I'm really looking forward to what this band has in store for the future. As I said, they have that four-way split... where they contributed a song to that, and that's really about it. I'm really hoping at some point we get a full-length album from this band, because I think they got a lot of potential. I mean, if this EP is any indication, I think they could put out a really killer full-length album. So, yeah, that is going to do it. I would give this a solid 9 out of a 10. I will leave a link down below so you can check this band out for yourself, pick up some merch, pick up a CD for Horror, Pain, Gore, Death. And, yeah, that is going to do it. Thank you guys so much for watching and subscribing. And until next time, stay brutal.